Doctors, in previous lectures of rotation, we studied a translational cum rotational motion and some examples. Now, for making concept more clear, we are taking some other easy examples on the same topic, translational cum rotational motion. After that, we will study about instantaneous axis of rotation, but firstly, I am taking some examples of that when. One of the example of translational cum rotational motion, suppose that is cylinder of mass m and radius r. It can rotate about its axis, that horizontal axis. It can rotate about this one. Axis is here fixed. Axis is fixed with cylinder. Suppose this. This cylinder, solid cylinder of radius r and mass m, can rotate freely about this given axis. Okay. A string is wrapped around circumference of the cylinder. It's wrapped. It's wound around this one. But a string cannot slip on the cylinder. And at another end, there is body of mass m. At a particular position, it is fixed. Whenever this mass is released, after some time this mass is released. After releasing this mass, we have to find out tension in this string and acceleration of this body. Two things we will need here. Okay. This mass, this block of mass small m, will be moving linearly, and simultaneously this cylinder will be rotating about its fixed axis. In this question, in the given system, a particular part of the system, this block, is moving translationally and another part is rotating. So that is a type of translational cum rotational motion. Now we want to find out tension and acceleration of this body. Okay. And another thing, there is sufficient friction between a string and cylinder due to which this string is not slipping on the cylinder. Okay. Firstly, we are making equation for this block M. For block small m. For FBD, there would be force Mg downward, vertically downward, there would be tension vertically upward, and we can have mg minus of tension T is small m mass into acceleration of the body. Okay, mg is taken positive, means downward direction is taken positive here, that's why this tension is taken upward and negative, acceleration is also downward, so I'm taking this one. I hope you do not have any confusion in sign of these quantities. Okay, that is first equation. Second one, we are making for this rotating cylinder about its fixed axis. This tension will cause, this tension is tangential, so it will cause torque about this fixed axis for this cylinder. And if tension is this T, its torque T into R, TR sin theta, where theta is 90, because everywhere this tension will be tangential to the cylinder. So this T into R is torque tau. I can write down torque tau. Torque. I'm sure you know that will be I alpha. Since this string is not slipping on the cylinder, so we should have relation A equals to R alpha. That's also true. Okay. From the second equation, second and third, we can write it T into R. Torque, this torque T into R will be, this is cylinder, that's why we can write down I half capital M R square, and alpha should be written down, this is I, alpha should be equal to A by R. A by R is equal to alpha. You know, this R, one of the R will be cancelled. This R and this R will be cancelled, and this T equals to half M, half M A. We can write down half M A, because there is R square, one of the R is cancelled with this one, and another one with this one, this one. We can put the value of T in equation first. I'm writing here from equation first. Mg, small mg, minus T is a small ma. We can have mg minus of T, T is minus of capital M A by 2, is a small ma. I hope you understand this thing. Mg equals to, this is brought here, small m plus capital M by 2 A, and acceleration can be written down as small m upon small m plus capital M by 2 G. Now we can write in different way that this is acceleration for this body. And in the same way, we can find out tension. How can we find out tension? We can put this value of A in this equation and we can get tension. So this tension will be, may I rub this one? Right. This tension. Right. This tension equals to half MA. Just I am writing here. Tension equals to half capital M A. Tension is half capital M, and you know this M. M is, A is a small m g into small m plus capital M by 2. And once again you can write down small m capital M g by 2 small m plus capital M. We can write down further this one, but this is tension or this is strength. Okay, so we can, for this type of question, translational and rotational motion, firstly we should make equation for linear motion, total force on the body equals to mass into acceleration. Second one, we should write equation for torque, total torque equals to I alpha. If there is no slipping, we can take A equals to R alpha, and linear velocity V equals to R omega, and by these equations we can solve this type of question. Okay, I'm taking one more example of the same type. I'm taking second example, but of the same time. Here there is cylinder. We are viewing its cross-sectional surface, and it is wrapped around the string many times. Many times it is wrapped around. The string is wrapped around the circumference of this disc, that is disc of mass M and radius capital R. Then this one of the end of this string is here fixed. it is released at t equals to 0. After releasing, this will be unwound and falling downwards. Now in this case, we have to find out tension and acceleration of this disc. Acceleration of this falling disc and tension in this string. That is another example. Once again, here the same body is translating and rotating both. Same body. In previous question, translational motion was performed by different block and rotational motion was performed by different body whose axis was fixed. Here axis is moving. Okay. But the method will be same. Means we have to find out firstly equation for translational motion. What about equation of this one? This mg will be downward. So I am writing mg, tension will be upward. So mg minus t is ma. A is acceleration of center of mass of the cylinder. This is one of the equation. Next equation for torque. Tension into radius r. This is torque for this one. Another force mg will not give any torque about axis passing through its center. Because this mg weight is intersecting the axis of rotation, that is center of mass, axis passing through center of mass. So mg will give no torque, only this tangential force, tension will give torque. And this t into r is net torque, that's equals to I alpha. I can have I half mr square, because this is disc. We can write down I means moment of inertia of any shape of body, which shape is given to you. But here I have given already disc, that's why I am taking formula of I half mr square. A can be written down, this alpha can be written down A by r. I am writing directly A by R, because there is no slipping, that's why alpha is A by R or A equals to R alpha. It means, once again, we can write down torque. One of the R will be cancelled here. This R will be cancelled by this one, and this is half MR. You can put this value of tension T in equation first. Here I am writing. From equation first, mg minus of t means half ma, sorry, both are cancelled, that's why half ma equals to ma. So here mg equals to 3 by 2 ma. And A equals to 2G by 3. A equals to 2G by 3. This is the acceleration of center of mass of the cylinder. That is 2G by 3. In the same way, we can find out tension half MA. From this one, we can write tension T equals to half MA. Half M. A is 2G by 3. 2G. Okay, that is mg by 3. This tension is mg by 3. So we can find out acceleration and tension of this type. We will take more examples, but now I'm going to discuss about instantaneous axis of rotation in further video. Thank you very much. Please subscribe and share this channel, Kamlesh Pandey Classes, Kamlesh Pandey Lectures, and oblige me.